Hi, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to DreamHack Open Stockholm.
Yes.
It's Counter-Strike Global Offensive time. It's the deciding match of Group B. Who's going to take second seed? Who's going to be going home? But 3D Max just sent Copenhagen Wolves home, one of the Danish teams. Are they the Dane killers tonight, Anders? So we're about to find out, because Team Dignitas, they're waiting.
They are waiting. And could you tell me, could you read at the bottom, that side, what map is it?
Cash?
No.
It's Dust 2! Dust 2, I vaguely remember this map. Somehow.
Vaguely remember it.
If I really reach back, you know, I remember seeing players once play on Dust 2.
Now, this, I think, makes a big difference for Dignitas. I think Dignitas have a pretty good chance of doing this on Dust 2. Better than they do on Cash. They're a strong team on this map.
They're a strong team.
And they're a hard team to deal with, I would say, overall.
Especially...
The pre and device combination seems to work very well on this particular map. So I think it's going to be, it's going to be tough for 3D Max. But I would have said the same thing about, you know, Copenhagen Wolves. So
yeah,
the Finns have impressed me either way tonight.
Tonight is a night of surprises, isn't it? NiP no longer in the tournament. Fnatic struggling to get that first seed. And now Dignitas, and now 3D Max taking out Copenhagen Wolves. That's an upset right there. Honestly, when we got into this, we were expecting there to be a Copenhagen Dignitas rematch for the second seed. And so already Wolves out of the picture, 3D Max into the picture. And it's a very pretty picture. Hey, this is going to be sick. Finns versus Danes.
Not as pretty as if Sean Gaius was in it, but still good.
I know. Well, we can't get everything, right, Anders?
Just can't. All right. Yes, we are going to be on Dust 2. And, at the same rate, 3D Max is obviously going to be well worse than Dust 2. It's not like they are going to be playing badly on it at all. And if Karan can keep up his ridiculous streak on like he had on Cash, just keep that up on Dust 2. And I think if Exart can be oping just a tiny bit better, they're definitely well within sort of striking range. But I would say if I had to throw bets on this game, I would say it's like 65% in favor of Dignitas here.
If you had to bet every single Asimov you own, you would put it all on Dignitas?
Yes.
Okay, then.
I would.
You wouldn't even go for the outside bet?
Nope.
Considering the odds?
Nope. Yeah, well, if it was an 80-20 bet, I would. If it was 20% in favor of 3D Max here, I might try. If it was less than 20, I definitely would. That would be an easy bet choice for me.
You'd be putting all your Asimovs?
Yep.
All of them?
All of them. If there was less than 20%, yeah. In a best of one game, yes. But, when it's a best of one line, this I say like 65%, and at that point I chose the.
Okay, I mean I'm not going to fight you on this because I think Dignitas are favored in this match as well. I think any sane person would say that Dignitas are favored in this match. It's absolutely possible that in a best of one scenario, 3D Max come up huge and manage to take out Dignitas. That would be the biggest upset this entire tournament long. So we'll see if it's possible here. Getting into this match, 3D Max definitely going to be putting up a fight with the tournament life on the line. Dignitas, as we can see, getting ready for the pre-match hustle and the huddle.
Shaking it up, clapping their hands and getting ready.
Camera's there.
I like this. Loosey-goosey,
Dupree. Loosey-goosey.
I wish we could hear what they were saying because I could do some live translation, but I don't read lips, so...
So apparently Dignitas RCT on Dust 2, so they will be starting off on the defense. And that's actually a bit of a problem here because their defense is so good. It's really going to come down to some fine precision play on 3D Max's part to be able to crack them.
What are they saying?
Well, this is when you need to be like really good at lip reading, Anders. What is Fetish saying?
Well, he was touching his arm and he was touching his neck before, so I actually think he's saying, I really sore neck, so Sipmix, you're going to give me a massage first, and then it's going to be you device, and now look at that. The pre-third in line, so he's pretty... our producer has certain challenges he has to try and overcome, and it's not working so well. And there it is. Look, I'll massage you first. He's not good at it, but he's got his hands in the right place.
Yeah, it's a combo massage. Yeah. He expects Dupree and Sipmix to go for the teamwork later.
There's some
on.
Tension between the teams. Here. You can see device.
Dupree's just like, dude, you need to put on some deodorant. This is vicious.
Okay, here we go. It's the full five-way massage going on. It's a very emotional and slightly erotic moment going on here on the stream. So we apologize for that, but hopefully all the children have already gone to bed here.
Oh,
and now
Sweden.
we are moving into the match very soon here. But that was the Dignitas team huddle there. Translated, and I do actually do lip reading, so it was an accurate translation.
Yeah. That hotel room later.
Yeah.
It's going to be a party. I'm curious if they're gonna if they brought some bacon with them too.
Actually, they should have because it's very hard to get this stuff in Sweden. You know, it's not the same.
I was trying to imagine what was gonna be in a Danish like survival kit. Say you were out in the wild in a random situation. You got a group of Danes out in the wild. What do you have in that kit, Anders?
I don't know. We'll have to come back to that. I do actually know that the Danish equivalent of the SEAL team is actually one of the best in the world. They have like SEAL Olympics, like Special Force Olympics, and the Danes are some of the best in the world at it. But so like, they do know some sort of survival. Me, probably not so much. I just stay indoors, try and survive
there instead. Probably because they're serving bacon at lunch, and the faster they get those exercises over with.
Okay, all right, let's get it on here. It's the final match of the day, ladies and gentlemen. So welcome to the show. This is DreamHack Stockholm, and whoever wins here is going to be going on to face the rest of the teams in Globen tomorrow, the Ericsson Globe here in Stockholm. And it's already Fnatic, it's Titan, it's LDLC has gone through. If you lose, you're out of it, together with NIP and Copenhagen Wolves and Alternate.
Yeah, that's the thing. NIP are out in a group phase, so this has blown the tournament wide open. But now getting into Group B, already 3D Max gathering up for a cat push. There's only device here to hold. The focus is on long right now for Dignitas.
And look at this, 3D Max have actually already set up position. Oh, are they going to fall back? If they keep going here, they have some really, really good post-plant positions. So device already falling back, and they are going to go for it. Device looking for the headshots, going to pick up now too, but the bomb is going to go down, and that's all 3D Max wanted. Now, look where they are on the rest of the map. They can just cover this from short, and they're defending from back there already. This could be really great. Reflex running up, the bomb is being defused. They're going to go quick. Oh no! They lose short control, and Fetish is still on this. Disturbed, he can't get back up here. The Danes, they may have done it anyway. They're going to get the defuse, and that was a very, very great idea from 3D Max. I have such a lot of appreciation for how 3D Max ran this round. They had that planned out. You can see when three members were on short, they had one guy down on long and one guy in lower dark. That was an immediate indication that it was going to be that kind of push, essentially. A very big tell that only we could see. Dignitas couldn't. Mm-hmm. That can work. That can definitely work with 3D Max. Very well thought out pistol round, but Dignitas were just a little bit too fast.
Yeah, that's the issue. And that they also managed to pick off the man in lower dark. So that crossfire kind of floundered there for Team 3D Max. And when it came down to it, they weren't able to stop the defuse happening on that site. It kind of worked against them. A good smoke put up by Dignitas as well to keep 3D Max off of that cat play. So it looks like 3D Max, they want more of the same. They're going to go rushing straight up cat this time around. But Device is having a field day with them. The P250 going to work. And he's just picking up frags left and right. He will finally get overwhelmed. But Reflex is going to step in. It's going to be Sipnik's Fetish just fragging everybody. They can't stop the plant, though.
Yeah, and that's the big deal. One kill, one bomb plant. That's all 3D Max wanted, which means in the upcoming round, wondering if they could go for an AWP, because they've had two bomb plants here. Obviously, they're going to be buying no matter what, but they might be able to even go for a glass cannon AWP here. And that could be something really, really early, before Dignitas can get it.
They're going to have a lot more gear, that's for sure. I mean, basically, it's pretty much, okay, you're going to have full nades, you're going to be able to have full AKs, and there you go. Full nades, full AKs, even the AWP picked up on XR. No Kevlar, though, but a flash to pick up on that as well.
Yeah, and actually, Device does have his, obviously, he had a pistol that last round, I just forgot about that. So, yeah, Device has an AWP too, and he's been boosted all the way up here. Looking for a grenade down there, does spot a couple of people, and actually does decent damage. Would have been better if he had waited a second longer and got the AWP shot off, but it's still worth getting.
3D Max, I don't know, that would have been touch and go there. He probably could have got that off shot off, but 3D Max peaked at the same time, both of them. So maybe he kills one guy, but the goal of that play there was for 3D Max to pick him off and return the frag. So that was a decent situation there. 3D Max now managing to do a little bit of damage to Dupree. That's a Caron. We're going to be watching a lot of Caron here in this map. He's going to be kind of the linchpin here for 3D Max, I think. He had a very strong performance on cash, did a lot of work for them versus Copenhagen Wolves, so we need to see him come up big here versus Dignitas to kind of even the tables.
Now, the way they're shaping up right now, wouldn't be surprised if we're going to end up with something that looks like a B-split. They still have a bunch of grenades and smokes, but they're moving up short instead, in fact, and the setup here is not that bad for Dignitas if Sipnik can hit the shots.
Yeah, he hears them. Sipnik hears them, but then again, he didn't hear them continue up there, and Device hasn't spotted anybody either. So this is still kind of up in the air as to where 3D Max wants to go. Only problem is they've got 25 seconds left. Device is now going to get in position to be able to stop this push. He has to shut down one place, but he's going to get caught. Caron, he's not managing to land the shot. Takes out the P250 and gets the job done, but it's too late.
Yeah, not looking good right now. AC alone and 10 seconds left. If they had held on just a little bit longer and if they'd killed not just the one, but two people over on short, that would have been the bomb drop, and very likely 3D Mesh would have no time to actually win the round. But now instead, AC's just walking out of here, so yeah, nicely time push on 3D Max. And this is the problem with the kind of setup that Dignitas had here, is that it all hinges on Fetish down in the pit. As soon as he goes down, you can see the device actually had to readjust himself, and that readjustment came just when 3D Max pushed. So it's down to Fetish going down, and it's down to 3D Max actually timing their push correctly. Mm-hmm. Those two factors made all the difference in this one round.
Yeah, managing to get up Cat so quickly. Also, device not managing to land that first shot on Corona. If he could have done that, then he would have a little bit of breathing room and things kind of stabilize a little bit for Dignitas. But him having so much trouble landing that first shot there. So a bit of a slip up there on device's part. But still, Dignitas definitely not out of this. They're on the board. But 3D Max now looking to apply some pressure. They're going to be able to get through this with three guys living. So they'll have money going into this to buy up and get pretty well equipped. Dignitas as well, but no AWP this time around for Dignitas.
Yeah, they only saved the FAMAS on the CT side, so yeah, they're going to be purchasing more FAMASs. They do have a lot of grenades, so I guess that's really more important at this point. Looks like it's going to be a V push here, and it's a nice opening kill for Dupree. AC trying to do a little bit more, now he just has to buy time. He can't reload even. He's got 9 bullets left, and he's going to have to go for more than this one kill that he's got, but it's not going to work out. Natu with a very nice flick there from the AK. Device flashing himself in, wants to pick somebody off, but that is going to put them at a man disadvantage.
Yeah, and disturbed.
Two man disadvantage, sorry. Grenade. Oh, ho, ho. That took Karan down to 8 health. Very close. So.
And Dignitas, they aren't even having a part of this. They know it's a 2-on-4 retake situation, that 3D Max are going to put the bomb down now. Question is, do 3D Max pick up on this fact? They haven't heard a thing so far from Dignitas. They don't see anybody in Upper Dark. Do they pick up on the fact that Dignitas are trying to save, and do they go hunting for them?
It might be a bit early to go hunting fully. They can't have that much money, but I don't know. I think, so the guy we see, the corpse laying up there on the plateau, is actually AC. And Device died in the window, and I'm pretty sure that AC and Device were close enough to each other that if they had actually waited, they could have both peeked at the same time, one behind box, one from window, because they could have bought more time with the flashbangs. But I think AC maybe didn't know how close Device was, so they ended up dying one at a time. A little bit unfortunate.
It was actually fairly far away on that rotation there for Dignitas. So Device, he did get there just, I mean, quite a few seconds behind.
Yeah, but I think the flashbangs could have bought time enough for AC to stay alive.
Well, as far as 3D Max are concerned, they're doing their jobs. Dignitas, they have those two guns. It's going to be a hard eco for the rest of them. They don't have too much money. Xart, not going to find a shot at long, so that's going to slow things down somewhat. He's going to have to reposition himself. But yeah, Sifnix is on a mission right now, and he's looking to find Xart. Xart could get completely outflanked, but he looks mid in time.
How did he know?
He's got Reflex to cover him as well, Xart. He's protected in this position. So long as Fetish can't round the corner fast enough or Xart doesn't go jumping past, and there you go. Reflex does not miss the opportunity. Great frag there.
There was nobody spotting Sipnix coming up middle. I'm pretty sure he didn't show on any radar on the 3D Max side. So that looked like Xart. Maybe someone did, because he looked up just at the right time. This is already playing on land, so there's no hacking or don't. That's not what I'm implying, but I'm really surprised by the fact that Xart managed to look up like that.
Game sense.
No, but the way he looked up like really quickly, like someone had, you know, just told him, by the way, there's someone right here. That's, I wish we could go back and watch the whole demo there from his point of view or from the 3D Max point of view. Well, disturbed in the middle here, it's gonna be walking up close, and Device actually does take him down. I've got to be a little bit careful, they don't throw away too much here. Dupree waiting at the edge of the smoke with a USPS. It's full James Bond mode for him. It's not quite good enough.
Oh. And they're just going to overwhelm the defense here. So Dignitas now going to have to reset. Fetish communicating, getting his ideas across here. Sipnix just pondering life.
I think he's wondering, how did Xart know that I was coming?
What's for dinner later?
What's for dinner later? Am I going to get that massage from Fetish?
Do they put bacon on burgers in Sweden?
It's a lot of questions to be answered.
All right. Enough of the bacon jokes. But we'll come up with something else. 3D Max right now, though, they still got control in this, and Dignitas going for a buy. So they did manage to have enough money to put together a reasonable buy. Again, no AWP picked up, so it's going to be Fetish rocking FAMAS. And he's always the one who's going to take the hit as well for his team. If it comes down to, you know, him, somebody having to drop a rifle for somebody else, or, you know, he'll just go for a straight P250 rather than saving money and going for a gun, he'll drop that for a teammate. So no surprise with the FAMAS on Dignitas. He wants to make sure that his mates have all the rifles. Or that M4 rifle.
Now, I was bragging earlier on about the the awesome power of device into Priya's rifle is on this map, and so far we haven't seen it yet, so I'm waiting for it to be put into play properly here, and maybe that's going to make a difference. They're using Exalt as a tool to get out the middle, kind of like Titan Wood with Kenny in this position, which is a really good idea, and if they smoke off CT spawn and go for B right now, it's going to be more than a little bit rough for Dignitas to hold on to it, I think.
It's going to be very tough indeed. Ha-ha, XR does manage to pick off Dupree. That's a very quick kill there, and that's going to weaken the defense here. AC going for a bit of a flash and peek, but he's not going to get anything out of it, and Caron is going to shut him down. Good smoke there down to cut off CT. Standard smoke, in fact, and Dignitas, once again, they aren't even going to make a play to try and retake or get frags. They just immediately fall back and try to hold on to the guns. Difference here is that 3D Max actually has... Well, they're already out on the hunt.
Yep. And this time, they should go and hunt for them. Because this time 3D Max have a few more rounds on the board and they haven't lost anyone yet. They must realize the Dignitas will be ecoing if they lose all the rifles here.
Device gets picked. Exart, he's here with the AWP. Device can't show himself. He can't risk it.
What on earth is the name of Device's gun? Can we switch back to Device?
Go back to Device? Device? What?
Oh, God.
this is some steel level naming here.
Well, no, Wells. we can't actually say the name of Steel Sniper. We're definitely going to get probably deported from
even
Sweden altogether.
Even in Sweden, we can't go that far. But that's all right, Device. Pretty good name.
Yeah.
You got some guys, you know, they're clever. They put their YouTubes, their Twitters.
Well, you know what? He's certainly making a name for himself. People are going to remember it. Whether or not it's for the right reasons, well, who knows. It's good that she was 18, though. Moving into the seventh round here. Gotta say 3D Max are off to a really strong start right now. Dignitas only really making their way through right now by saving rifles every round. But they're losing the rounds, but at least, you know, they're saving them, so they're kind of tagging on a little bit here. Not really being dropped all the way behind the truck, but we'll see. AC and Xart having a mental battle over here. Who's going to lose the patience first?
That's it. Who's going to crack first on the patience train? They still haven't smoked it up either. They're really holding on to their smokes here. Actually, the smoke just goes down at beginning of at entry to a banana.
AC has the rifle too. It's spreading. I can't contain myself any longer. All right, here comes the push. Flash right through on the other side of the smoke. Nicely played. Now they're already inside. AC pick up the bomb carrier and goes for a second one. Has the pistol out now, looking for a third kill and almost going to get it. Now two, barely surviving that one. A device comes in. That's the secondary rifle coming out here from Dignitas. Some shots being put through from Sibnik's, not connecting, but it's a 3-on-2 retake. And the Danes have to win this. They, like, mentally, they got to come back into this one. It's out very low on health, being trapped up under the plateau here. Got to connect with a lot of shots here, and they could come in from either angle.
Exactly. They're just trying to buy as much time, but that was a perfect entry flash right there. Device picks up Natu, who's trying to make a play for it, and Exart gets cleaned up by Fetish. Coming in from Upper Dark, that perfect pincer there for Dignitas, and done with poise as well, Dignitas. They didn't try and rush in. They didn't try to just overwhelm 3D Max immediately. They got into position. They put the right flashes in, and then went about business as usual. That was very nicely done there by the Danes. And all of this saving on their guns means that they're going to have a pretty healthy buy going into this right after this win. 3D Max is going to be curious to see what their money level is going to be like right now. But AC, this is also just huge play from him. Putting the nades out there and making sure that he can just set up and play the box right.
Oh, Device missing a shot there on Long. And I mean, Natsu actually just ran out against him. He didn't fake it first. He just went all in. That's a bit mad.
Well, he's got control of Long, and this is really taking up Device's attention.
Yeah, but this is a much better setup for Dignitas. This time around, they're controlling Short, and Device can much more reasonably control Long than he could Short when they had the reverse setup earlier, when they controlled not Short, but sort of Long, and then a bomb site. Much prefer this kind of style from Dignitas.
Yeah. Not Short, it's definitely Long.
See, it's all there is. Just
maybe it's middle.
Buckets of wisdom being poured on you guys here.
Alright, well.
Next up, we'll say that four kills are better than three.
Or three ops better than two.
That's what it is.
Dignitas. Dignitas, man, they're going right back. I mean, they're burning so much time with this clock. They decide to go back, change up their strategy. They're going to take control of Long now and leave Short to Device. And Device, he has to land some big shots, but a good flash there. That's going to open things up. Sipnix and Fetish teaming up, but Reflex lands a sick headshot, and Caron follows it up and picks off Sipnix. 3D Max are going to get right out onto this site now.
Yeah, that was a very, very cool free fire coming out from Reflex. He realized eventually someone's going to pop up here, and he clicked it just 1 second before. Damn, that was just fantastic. Now, Dupree and AC, again, making a run for it. Like we've been talking about earlier, Dignitas are kind of hanging on here because of how much they manage to save every round when they lose, which is not really great, but it, you know, it keeps them in the game right now because if it hadn't been for all these saves that they've had, very likely 3D Max could be up at like you know, 6-1 or something like that here. It could be terrifying.
Their money could be out of control as well. As long as they save, they can always try and get creative and go for a force. Device would be the recipient of one of these rifles. They may just hand it off to him, and we go to a camera shot. I'm really curious. I'm hearing a lot of movement so far right now. So not too sure exactly what the state is going to be. It sounds like maybe Dignitas are deciding to throw a curveball here and go for a buy.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they're buying. I feel pretty confident that they're going for a buy here.
Yeah, there it is. Okay, yeah, they're not wanting to let 3D Max get out of control here. They're definitely going to take this fight into free. AC with a double kill. This is big. Dignitas, this is the way the buy is supposed to work. They're going to bounce right back in here.
Yeah, oh, but Reflex still on point with the headshot. It's going to take down Device, who was strolling for a walk in that CT spawn.
That's the kind of pick that's going to open things up once again. They bring it back to a 3-on-4. 3D Max still have plenty of time on this clock as well. But Dignitas are playing this right. They're just falling back. And that's the point where it shifts. Dignitas now, they got a little excited. They walked into it and gave up one frag. Now they're going to just play the clock and make sure that 3D Max have to come to them. So in this position, Sipnix, he's going to be, he has that smoke just perfectly timed to land on Cat to stop that push coming in from 3D Max. But he's got a good position on A slope as well.
Yeah, if all of 3D Max goes slope, but actually we can kind of see they're thinking about it. They do have the smokes to go for a split push if they wanted to be as well. The Dignitas setup is good if they all come slope. It's bad if one of the 3D Max members go for long. That's where it gets really tricky for the CT side. But as it's shaping up right now, I think they're just faking it out. I think they're going to end up going out middle instead.
Yeah.
So yeah, leaving one guy short here. AC's jumping around a little bit, and he moves just as Xart comes in. So very unfortunate timing then. Xart not going to get the shot through, but there's still one guy in the B-bomb site. It's Dupree, and he has to come up very big here.
Yeah, good flash there. What a casual headshot coming out, but Natu will shut him down. Dupree only going to get the one. Fetish is right outside the door, though, as this bomb is about to get planted. He decides to flash his way through. Is he going to manage to catch the man off guard? Gets the first one, but can't turn in time to get the second. And that is 3D Max now getting up to seven rounds, or six rather, Dignitas.
And this time they didn't save a single rifle. Mm-hmm. They wanted to go for the 1-on-2, and you can't really blame them, but that means they are going to be ecoing here. Good shot from Reflex here. They're trying, Dignitas. They're really trying, but 3D Max are proving a powerful team.
They certainly are. They've come into this with preparation. They're making the right calls as well. It's going to be an eco round set up here. Xart, danger of getting rushed down. Seems like he had a feeling for that as well. Now he's going to hold the gap. And Fetish is very close to this. If he can, they don't have any nades though on Dignitas. Like if there was a flash or something like that, maybe just go for a swag, throw the pistol, and go for the knife. I mean, if you're gonna go for it, just go for it, right? Now they're just gonna lie and wait, like powerful yellow and black pumas.
There must be a lot of tension right now on the Dignitas team. One thing is losing to Fnatic in overtime. I think, you know, they're not going to be excited about that, but I think most people could forgive them for not winning that match, even though they definitely could have. But if they lose this one to 3D Max, oh, people are going to be throwing some words at them.
Oh, it's going to be completely out of control if that happens. And 3D Max, I mean, that's just a massive upset. I mean, to get into the semifinals, to be able to play at Globen, this is the thing.
Well, the most exciting thing about this is that we're obviously going to have to rethink our position on what kind of team 3D Max is, because they've always shown some potential, but they never really made the breakthrough properly. And right now, they're showing there's a lot more beneath the surface than what we previously thought here. Device coming up from behind, and a nice dance from Xart here. He's not quite going to save him. Device looking for a second kill and could get it if he just finds Disturbed, who's hanging around with one health. Finally, someone has the common sense to tell him to get back behind the line there.
I think that was a combination interpretive dance of, you know, how did that guy get there? Where is my team? And please, God, reload this gun faster.
Yeah. Send the video to Jordan, and I'm sure he can actually help us out with with figuring out how that dance actually works out there.
That's the please stop shooting at me while I reload dance.
Yeah.
And Device continues with a P2K, no less. He's going to get out of here with an AK. This is a great save for him. He's forced 3DMAX to spend a lot of money, and he's going to save some money. That's 2,700 bucks in his pocket now for the next round.
Yeah, very annoying player Device there, just never giving up. So yeah, it's going to be good. Right now, I would say Dignitas need whatever they can get. You know, saving an AK here and there, getting an extra kill in. The priority for the Danish team has to try and make this 8-7. They have the AWP already. Xart ready with a shot down the middle. Not going to connect with anything, though. This is Dignitas' time to turn it around. Because if this keeps going, there's a chance that they might not make it into the main part of the tournament. And that it's already an upset that 3DMAX beat Copenhagen Wolves. If they keep going here, it's going to be just a plain miraculous.
Incredible. They do manage to peek. They do spot somebody holding that angle there. So Sipnix has given away his position. So 3DMAX just kind of floating around, gathering info on where they're holding, what they're doing. And once they've computed all of that, 3DMAX will be able to make the call, make the play. Reflex is going to be taking point, kind of sneaking around. They're going to go ahead and set this up. Smokes to go down to cut off that angle that Sipnix was holding on. Flash to follow. Double nade combo, though. Reflex eats that.
Yeah. That's a worthy investment. $300 just to get Reflex down that low, especially because how well Reflex has been playing. Again, with a good time smoked here coming out from the CT side, just keeping 3DMAX back a little bit. And they have another smoke here on Sipnix, so getting through now is probably going to be really tough, I think, for 3DMAX. This could be a problem for them. Maybe the one guy to open up would be Reflex down on long, because there's a heavy presence here at the A bomb site for Dignitas.
Yeah, follow-up smoke to go down. The flash to slow things down, but they're going to get out onto Cat 3DMAX, and they don't suffer any losses for now. Sipnix not quite connecting with the shots, and he's going to get overwhelmed. Disturb lands the headshot. Device gives away his position here in Goose, but they're going to peek him together. Yes, they do. Managed to get rid of him, and now it's looking like a 3DMAX round in the blink of an eye. Four frags. And yeah, there we go. Showing some emotion. There's the high five. Yeah. And 3DMAX are looking very good right now on Dust2.
They absolutely are. And if you just rewind the time back again to the pistol round where they tried to do that thing where they got into the bomb site, but they left a couple of people behind, you know, sort of playing for the long con for when they get into the bomb site, they're already set up for whoever's going to be coming up mid. They did the same thing this round with Reflex waiting around. And that shows you that 3DMAX has, they've thought about this quite a bit. Before they actually go into these rounds. It's very cool.
Well, now they're just going to go for the straight play onto B. They know that somebody was wounded over here. Fetish is going to be the first man down. He was the one who got tagged by the AWP, though, so there's a lot more HP on the rest of these Dignitas members. But 3DMAX managed to get out onto this site unscathed.
Yep, and they make a run for it, so 9-3.
A bit far from unscathed, but still, they get out onto the site.
Four health summoners, that's three too many. They're going to be fine. It's right. No problem for Coron.
He's just going to walk it off.
Yeah.
Go hunting some Dignitas members, perhaps? I mean, 3DMAX, they do have quite a bit of money, actually. They can afford to go hunting right now.
Yeah, that wouldn't be an unreasonable choice, but...
If Dignitas do manage to get through this round, holding onto, well, two rifles...
And some armor.
Yeah, and some armor.
I mean,
that's
total
not
of,
bad.
Total of almost 14,000 equipment value is what they have right now, as you can tell on the top left here. Right underneath the score. It's not always completely obvious, but it is up there somewhere. So there's actually a lot here for, normal equipment value starting is, well, you can kind of tell. It's a little bit over 26,000, what 3DMAX have. You add some grenades to that, then you're up there. So Dignitas kind of having half of what they should have that round. And, you know, losing one guy in B, that's all it took. 9-6, the absolute best scenario right here for Dignitas.
Wow. This is exactly, that's the best case scenario, and that's really what they have to aim for at this point. They need a little bit of space here. They are going to be swapping over to the T side, but it's really looking like 3DMAX has got this game dialed in right now. Pressure on long. Dignitas putting three guys down here to start, along with the AWP on Device. So they really look to stop any kind of early aggression coming out here from 3DMAX, but 3DMAX are willing to play the patience game. They're hanging back. They're not giving anything up. They don't want to eat the early nade damage in case the HEs come sailing in, and they don't want to give up the frag. So this is really patient play coming out here from the Finnish team.
Yeah, they've been showing a lot of that today. Mm-hmm. There's been a lot of instances where you could tell that they had it, but Reflex loses actually a little bit of that patience and decides to peek over right along, and Device was there for the early pickoff. Maybe a tiny moment of relief for Dignitas, but they still got to win the round.
Exactly. Exactly. And so far, 3DMAX, even if they are man down, they've managed to make it work somehow. So we have to see if they're going to find the proper angle to get in here. Device is holding from cross. So it's going to be an op-on-op fight. Who's going to win it? Exart Sure, he doesn't want to fully commit. It looks like his team are gathering up for the mid-door push, but then the bomb comes back up on Cat, and 30 seconds left. They're really cutting this close, 3D Max. They're not giving themselves a whole lot of time, a whole lot of room for error. The nades are going to go in, and with 20 seconds left, Device is going to get flashed, and here comes the push. 3D Max rushing out. Device lands the first shot, takes out Corona. He's got to get the follow-up as well, and this is how it's supposed to go. Device single-handedly nearly pushing down this stopping this push.
Yeah, follow-up grenades as well. The stub will take him down. Shouldn't be allowed to get the bomb down here, and indeed Fetish will be able to stop that from happening. So a really good round from Device there. Those three kills with the orb, especially the early one on Reflex, makes such a big difference in the round. So a tiny glimmer of hope, maybe.
Yeah, well played there by Device. And that one as well. As the smoke goes up, he still manages to spot out Exart. That's how that hold is supposed to go for the CT side with the AWP. Going to be the duel at mid. Device gets tagged, puts the shot through, but he's not going to hit anything. And in the meantime, 3D Max are just yoling straight down mid.
A lot faster than they've been the previous rounds here, so this is definitely an intentional switch up from the Finnish side. They want to see if the Danes are ready for this change of pace, and seems like they're not. Device very low on health here, and he's all alone at the bomb side. Gonna get shut down. Reflex and Disturbed step it up, and what a great time for the Finns to change the pace. Mm-hmm. That was well calculated, and now they're back holding short like they've been a lot of other times. Planting the bomb on that new side of the bomb site.
They've got very clever plans right now, 3D Max. They throw the smoke to make it look like it's going to be a B-split push, and then they run through that smoke into CT spawn. So they're all over the place. Double spray from Dupree, though. He steps in. He's tired of the shenanigans. He wants to get onto this bomb site and stop this plant from happening.
Oh, no. But
he's got behind. Time.
Reflex has been flanking all the way around, so he tries to fake it once here, and Reflex is going to shut him down, and that ends the round. It would have been great if it had only been Corona and CT spawn. Then it would have worked out great for them, but... Now Fetish looking to try and hold on to a rifle here, but it's going to be a 10th round for 3D Max, and no save either.
No save, exactly. Fetish, you can see him throw his head back in frustration there. He does manage to take her on with him with the bomb going up, but still, that's money that Dignitas needed to be saving in this round.
And it's not money that 3D Max need.
But that spray control there from Dupree. Well, with the M4A1, that's a high-pressure situation right there.
Yeah, when I was talking up Dupree and Device about rifling, mm-hmm. that's the kind of image I had in my mind. And this is maybe one of the few times we've seen it. So, yeah, it happens once, but it's not enough.
Looks like Exart heard the steps close. Is he going to find the opportunity here? Device is going to be holding this angle, but they're going to get really close. This is a good opportunity. Shot from Dexart. There's still a man holding close, and he's not going to get it. Down to 2 HP. Scary situation, and his teammates are crowding him. He can't get back through the doors.
They just want to get in here and kill these players. Dupree still alive. Smoke us up once, and they're going to... Are they going to retreat? They're scared of the Nova? Can't blame them.
Oh, yeah. Let's see. AC. Manly's gun. The Nova just has double walk. Face is looking, holding the cap though. He's looking for that headshot. Caron, not gonna find it quite yet. He's ducking down, and they're gonna try and adjust here. Dupree, he's acting as if he was one of the pack, and that's not gonna work.
The reason he was doing that is actually because he came from Lord Dark. He had run out from Lord Dark and into the middle, so they actually chased him through. And an absolutely beautiful first half here from 3D Max. It wasn't a fluke when they played well and defeated Copenhagen Wolves. They just are very much on point today, and this has been. Oh, this has been a learning experience, I think, from a lot of people involved.
Absolutely. This is just really impressive. Out of the Finnish team as well. Clear underdogs coming into this tournament, but today, at least, they're showing they've got some fangs. And this is now them on the brink of picking up a map on Dust 2. They swap over to the CT side, but Device have got a long road ahead of them. They've
and
only
actually,
got four rounds.
It being a Swedish event as well, I think it's going to be pretty exciting for the Finns to be up here. And one of the things I've noticed since the beginning of Global Offensive is that the Finnish fans have actually been... always very sort of visible. They're always out there cheering for their players. So that's very cool. Now they really have something to cheer for.
Oh yeah, Aces ROG, man. When Encore at the time, 3D Max now, were playing in the finals, the whole place was packed full. Everybody was there to watch. So it's very cool that 3D Max is getting this far, but we can't get ahead of ourselves here yet.
Yeah,
Dignitas. There is
that Swedish land, the Finnish land, sorry, you're right. Back in the day, I think Mindtrek was also in Finland. I think so, it's a long time ago. There used to be a cool frag movie. But now let's see. Dignitas making their way up on here to the A bomb site. They are going to get the bomb down, and actually they're going for nearly the same strat that 3D Max did. They plant on the new side, they retain short control. Apparently this is the new popular thing to do on Dust 2.
When they decide to take this fight through CT spawn.
on. Disturbed is going to catch AC, who was lurking down there, but Sipnix gets the perfect flank. He's going to get one headshot. Corone just casually turns around and shoots him in the face, though. But this is turning into a real battle, and this is a very tough situation for 3D Max to find themselves in. 2-on-1 now. They've somehow come out ahead, and Fetish is now the only man alive here. And Gandalf tries to pop the trap, but he's got to get the headshot, and he saves it for Dignitas. Fetish, you can see. Oh, they knew 3D Max. They knew they were close.
That was very close. The big question, which remains unanswered, is why on earth are they going for this fight here? They know that even if 3D Max make it up to the site, they still have to get short control before they can start that defuse. Essentially, Dignitas came seconds. Well, they gave them short control. They killed all of them. That was... I still think that was a big misstep from the Dignitas. Fetish saved them.
Yeah, Fetish. That was of all the clutch plays. And it was so crucial that Dignitas pick up that round. Device is going to manage to pick up Disturbed, who was the sole defender on the B site. So 3D Max, once again, going for a bit of a gamble, having four guys over on A, hoping that Dignitas were going to perhaps push up onto Cat or push out into long. 3D Max now, they're going to be floating around this, they're going to be floating around this map looking for exit frags at this point. And Fetish, he does it again.
Yeah, could get shot in the back, and yeah, Natsu turns around. He was almost there to actually save Ixart, but... maybe some exit frags could come in here for 3D Max if they find the right exit. But it seems like Dignitas are making their way at the other side, so maybe they're going to hold on to the last four rifles here.
Seems like Fetish, he didn't... did he have Kevlar? I don't think he had Kevlar.
Nope, he just had pistol and nothing else.
So basically,
just Glock.
It's going to be AWP play for Fetish.
Nicely done.
Nafu still managing to take one with him. That's a win in his book.
Yeah, that takes it from being kind of a neutral round for 3D Max into being a pretty good round. Two kills, not bad.
That's what it's all about. You have to think about the gear that's on 3D Max and then the gear that's on Dignitas. That's the trade that 3D Max are looking for. If they spent $300 or $500 on a P250 or CZ75 and they're able to take somebody who spent $3,700
yeah, or $3,000, right.
You know, that's a huge win. So that's the economic trade they're always talking about here in these eco rounds. If we say that a team, you know, may consider the round one, is because, okay, they got two kills and the dollar exchange there is going to favor them.
Oh,
hello.
That's beautiful. That's a five-man grenade. Even though the last guy only took four damage, that's still very rare to hit five people with one HE, and they're pretty angry. They're like a bee's nest here. As soon as they get a little bit disturbed, they just keep pushing. Sart's going to go down. Device will pick up that one kill, and over on long, Dupree's ready for the refugees from middle, trying to get over here, and actually they're doing some damage to him at least.
Does he get the fadeaway nade? Fetish does. Sipnix is going to manage it with Device, and this is going to be Disturbed. Last man alive here, going for the ultimate flank all the way through T-spawn, and it gets a double headshot on Device.
Surely there must be like an achievement to hit five people with one grenade.
There's got to be.
Maybe he already had it, but...
I'm sure, you know, Valve being Valve, though, they're going to be like, you have to kill five people with one nade to get that achievement, right? And it's the most sought-after achievement in the game until somebody spawns a map with five bots and just blows them up.
Yeah. Achievement hunting.
Fun times, right?
Disturbed. I mean, the one kill, but saving the AK makes it still a pretty decent round with 3D Max. I mean, considering the position they were in, I'd be happy with what they got out of this one. So it's still going to be 7-11, which means Dignitas are in the game still. I think 3D Max have a lead at the moment, but a lot comes down to this fourth round, because if they lose it, then it's not impossible for 3D for Dignitas to bounce quite far back in the game.
It's all about eco management at this point. 3D Max, this is their first buy round. Disturb still has $3,400. That's still going to be a good save for him, but... Fetish?
Oh my god.
Wow, he picks off Exart. That's just timing right there from Fetish.
Again, Fetish got to be happy that there's no Overwatch for these demos right here, because that would have got him banned almost instantly. Coral gets flashed in. Are they going to push up behind him? They're very close. He's got some backup here. And they're not actually committing to it. And that's probably good, because Reflex is here and he's pushing out. He's been great today already. And from the middle, Caron actually helping out, actually right behind him there with a kill on Dupree. And Device was too far away to help. So good return frag.
Yeah, Sipnix has currently snuck his way out onto long. He's going to get support there from Fetish, who's carrying the bomb. And who also has that AWP. So going to be keeping eyes on the angle there. 3D Max, if they were to come around and try and push and perhaps peek that angle to get info, they could be in for a rude awakening. Dignitas, they currently just slow down the pace. They still have 50 seconds, so there's no reason to rush. They're just slowly going to work their way up here and see if they can't get eyes on a site.
Yeah, but I think actually Dignitas have a better position right now than 3D Max do because of the smokes. They can smoke off the crossover, and it's going to be still really tricky for Reflex and Caron here.
Next level. Why use the smoke when you can be a ninja? And save the smoke for later, for your vanishing act.
Yeah, they're going to smoke it when they're close at least. And that's going to give 3D Max really little time to work with. Already jumped over quick here. And Caron over on short takes down AC. He's very little low on health here. And he's still picked up that double kill. And they don't know about Reflex in the corner yet. And that's a big deal.
Yeah, bomb has been planted though. And they do manage to keep this alive. Reflex alive. And Gandalf takes a peek towards the site. Gives away his position. But this is still going to be a close in situation here. Corona's managing to pick up device. They're going to come rushing up CT slope, but Sipnix and Fetish managed to pick up the frags, and it's into a 2-on-2. Now a 2-on-1. Fetish once again has to clutch it for his team from Long Plateau.
And he gets that first kill. Now Corona has a tough choice to make. Is he going to try and run for it, or is he going to wait? Fetish peeks once, and Corona has to make a run. No time to get this done. So a quad kill from Corona. In spite of the fact that he very early on actually got shot down to 27 health, he is still a really big force here on the Finnish side. But Dignitas do win it. They save the AWP. And the Danes take one step further. And the big thing is that 3D Max can't have a lot of money now. The one ult that they saved here might be all they get. And this initial shot, yeah, that's one for the books.
That is definitely one for the books. Where's the back band when you need it, right?
Yeah. Oh, they actually, they did have something. They had more than I thought.
They're still able to put together a pretty reasonable buy. They don't want to let Dignitas get any momentum. And they know, the thing is, that's what's going through 3D Max's mind at this point is that they know they've done so much damage to Dignitas throughout these rounds that Dignitas can't have much of a bank.
Look, the Reflex, he's in the smoke hiding. They don't know he's got the Max 7. If he just gets a kill here, it'll be worth it. And the smoke's going to fade. He comes out and he misses. Oh, it's right in the middle of them with a shotgun. You think that's almost impossible.
That there were too many targets. He got confused.
Yeah. Oh, man.
It is. It is. That is definitely frustrating, though. When you manage to lay the trap, you spring it, and then it whiffs air. Oh, yeah. Especially with the Mag 7, that's $900 per kill there. So if he could have picked up a couple of frags, that's a lot of money in the bank. But it's not meant to be. Exart on the side, however, is going to be looking for a shot. But Dupree finds the angle and gets the headshot first.
Nicely done. Trying to get some crossover kills here as Corona. And actually, Disturb will pick up Device anyway. So, well, Bomb is pretty going to go down here any second. But it's a 3-on-3. And can they hold on to it? AC. Stunning headshot coming in. But they keep getting returned on. Corona must have been jumping and shooting to take down AC here. They're trying to make it back down long again, and Sipnix will help out, and now it's even better than last time here for Dignitas.
Yeah, exactly. Smoke is gonna go down.
No kit.
He needs to kill off, he needs to kill Sipnix just fast. If he can kill Sipnix, this happens, but yeah, no kit means this is an impossible situation. This baits Sipnix out. Fetish is just running up as well. And Fetish is gonna get, no, he runs out of bullets. Disturbed had it. He is gonna get the kill. Will he be able to save this gun, though? He trades out for the AWP. Will that half-second cost him? He's going to be able to make it out alive. So 3D Max still able to save the AWP despite everything.
And Dignitas quite jumpy at that situation. They committed both players to shooting through the smoke there just out of sheer panic and fear that they were going to lose the round because of it. Obviously, they couldn't know if he had a kit or not. But yeah, that kind of panic can actually come back to, I mean, that's the kind of panic that's going to make them make the wrong decision in a really tight moment. So they got to be careful here. I mean, they're at 7-11, or 9-11, sorry, so they're close to, and this time they're going to go for the straight B push. Finds one guy in the corner, Disturb. He's going to trade one, and Natu takes a lot of damage, just barely makes it out, though.
Oh, and he's going for the Grandma Toss Nade. He's got the flash in there. He's still going to be able to apply some pressure, at least listen very closely. But they do manage to pick him off with a nice HE in the end, and it's going to be a man advantage for Dignitas here. Reflex and Exart looking to see if they can't get control of Lower Dark, but guess what? Dupree is here first. Shuts him down with a shot to the face. Exart comes around the corner. So that opens up a path for escape, and he's going to take it.
Oh, already hunting. So Dignitas, this is very different. If you remember the first half, 3D Max were a lot more hesitant with going for these hunts. It's not like Dignitas have a lot of money, so that's not what it's based off. This is just based off the idea that they don't want him having this AWP, but Xart's in a pretty good position to hold it here. If they work together, there's one guy in CT spawn as well, and actually he misses that shot. Grenade to follow. That's a very quick flick, and he's got 4 health. And Sipnix is coming for him, looking with that AK. Xart scoped up the wrong spot, and it's worth it for them to do that. Even though they lost a couple of rifles running after at least one there, it's still a good idea. So no AWP saved. And 3D Max, I think they're going to be ecoing here.
Yeah. Yeah, not being able to hold on to that gun is going to make the difference here. That would have been fantastic for 3D Max to have going into this. That flick, though, that's just insane.
It's very, very fast.
Always fun to watch AWPs. Always. Never get bored. The reflexes on these players are just so incredible. Oh! Disturbed. He just barely makes it out of there. Oh, the nade! Oh, that nade down to 12 HP.
Yeah, and then the follow-up nade did 1 damage, which is kind of funny. Sipnix in the corner here, it's going to be the eco spray down, and actually he only gets the two here, and they're losing a couple of players. If they'd lost device then, that would have been really scary. So DreamHack, well-timed push, and they get something for it. It's been tied now, 11-11. From a first half where Dignitas has only picked up four rounds, they're now back to 11-11. So that's got to mean something right here.
Exactly. Well, Dignitas, it's the freight train, man. It's the freight train. Once it gets rolling, the billion tons of bacon and steel, and you're just not stopping it.
Yeah, but it's on the terrorist side, right? I mean, it's a little bit different from the normal Dignitas team, at least. Mm-hmm. Let's see if they can continue, or if this is going to be the round where the Finns decide enough is enough. We are going to be able to make it through to Globen here, but Disturb in a huge amount of trouble. And there's that rifling that we were talking about. Dupree now really coming into it. Mm-hmm. Definitely lacking in the first half, no doubt. But that kind of opening is worth a hell of a lot. And now Dignitas, look at how fast they are again. Bomb is down, and already three or four out of the members are actually out of the bomb site looking.
Oh yeah, they have the money to be able to rebuy. This definitely makes sense for Dignitas. Reflex, everybody's kind of gathered up around long right now for 3D Max. They're just going to try and hold this angle and make sure that it's a blender, basically. If Zipnix comes running out, he's going to get shredded. But the nade, that is a very clever play there by Zipnix. He knows what's going on, and he still makes it out of there.
Yeah, but now they actually have Reflex trapped in the corner, so are they going to be able to wallbang through quite enough? No, he's actually going to be able to escape here. Bomb's going to go off any second now. 3D Max, just a few more seconds in this round, and they're going to come up with three rifles, and that'll be big. Remember, saving rifles is actually what kept Dignitas in the first half at all. Mm-hmm. So 3D Max can emulate that at this point in the game. They're doing something right. 22 kills on Disturbed, actually, who's taken over for Coron and Reflex, who were doing really well earlier. And Device is at 21 on the other team.
Yeah, Device is certainly having a good performance, but Dupree, I think, is the man here. He had a very rough start to this to the first half, and he's starting to wake up here now that it's swapped over to the T side. Good flash, that's going to slow things down here, but 3D Max, Natu eating a flash of his own, still gets the shot, and Disturbed has picked up one as well on the other side.
It's looking really good here. Disturbed coming in for another one. Molotov goes out as well. It's going to force Fetish back, and the bomb goes down, sure, but I don't think they can hold this bomb site. The Danes may have overextended themselves here. The push, it worked once, but this time, there's not much Fetish can do anymore.
Yeah, they've already got him backing off. He's 1v4, and he's on the other, he's on the wrong side of a smoke. What?
Yeah.
For a second there, I was... How ridiculously sick would that be if he just happened to hit where the wall, you know, like you can wallbang the wall with an op, well, and he stopped that from happening?
If this was 1.6, you can actually wallbang through that that car spot. Not anymore. It's a fun, you know, that was fun times in 1.6 when you can actually stand in that corner and you could hear people running through. Mm-hmm. If you're there fast enough, and especially if you're good at bunny jumping, just shoot right through as people came in. Long time ago. Fetish going to be walking out here and looking for the corner. Flash goes in and he can't get the timing down right, but he wants another peek at it, and that's going to give him a leg shot on Reflex. Big risk, I would say, to run re-peeking that.
Yeah, exactly. As soon as you know. But Fetish, he sticks around. He's willing to confront the nade damage, essentially. X-Art, not going to find the angle fast enough. AC gets the punish, but Disturbed is there. It's a double push into Upper Dark, a triple push, in fact. So a one-for-one trade here, and Team 3D Max are going to have to back off a little bit.
They get the bomb down for free here.
Exactly.
As long as they keep short control, not like they did in the pistol round, but actual short control, just sticking with it, they're going to be in a great position. This could be Dignitas taking the round lead again.
Very limited nades here for Dignitas, though. They've only got two smokes and a couple HEs.
The backstab from spawn.
Now, this could be huge, but there's a counter backstab. Oh, but no. Zipnix here is not too stomping around, so he knows that somebody's floating around here. And you can already tell he's just trying to make up his mind, where do I want to look?
Thunder thudding, as Corey Dome would have called it. Good Molotov coming in, but yeah, Natu's going to get shot in the back by Zipnix. You're right, he made too much noise. Device goes down, but it doesn't really matter. The bomb is on the right side here, so how are 3D Max going to do this? They've actually smoked it off, and Dupree comes through, has to find the shot. He's defusing right in front. He's going to keep holding it down. 3D Max get the round. Fantastic play. That is so cool. They save that smoke, and they get it home. Very nicely done.
And a split second later, they both die as well. So that was just such a close call there for 3D Max. That smoke on Cat just did everything for them. Even though Dupree, he manages to get his bearings and see where the guy's defusing, he can't land the shot. And that was everything now. It's into a 13-12 situation. 3D Max have taken the lead once again after Dignitas had tied it up. And Dignitas, they are getting straight out onto A-Long. But look at this push. It's a Titan push coming out here from 3D Max, and they don't land the first shot. The element of surprise is gone, but they still get the damage in.
Oh my god, and the most ridiculous thing is that Fetish was actually scoped up on that corner up until 1 second before they moved out. If they'd pushed 1 second earlier, Fetish had the scope right on that edge. So that is some creepy timing coming in here from 3D Max. They're just three rounds away from knocking Dignitas out of the DreamHack Stockholm tournament here. And that means the Danes won't be making it to Globen tomorrow, but the Finns will. Yeah.
That was kind of silly.
Playing hide and seek and starts like, I found you.
It's like those kindergartners, you know, or like they aren't. You know, they're too young to realize that, yes, okay, you can hide behind the drape, but if I see your feet, you're not actually hiding just because you can't see me. You
know, it's like, something like that.
So it's just like, if I don't move, the decision is based on movement.
However this ends, it's been a really exciting game, I think. It's already proven some really high-level Counter-Strike here, and we're not even at the main part of the tournament yet. Still just best of one territory. Backstab coming in again. Reflex very low on health, but he's got enough to take. Well, Ixart's going to do it first, but he would have had enough anyway. Sipnik's trying desperately to put the bomb down, and this bomb is... He knew for sure he wasn't going to win it, but the $800 bonus here, it makes all the difference for them. That probably is going to give Dignitas another attempt at a buy that exactly. They wouldn't have had otherwise.
Exactly. 800 bucks for everybody. That's near a full set of nades right there, minus a flash. You can see the focus right now in 3D Max. They are definitely dialed in. It's got to be very frustrating over on the Dignitas side, though. They've got to be wondering what the hell is going on here. But the Finns are playing magnificently. The little peekaboo moment there with Device.
Yeah, so they could buy a little bit here. Fetish hoping for that moment. And look at this push coming out from Lower Dark. Are they going to realize it? One flash goes in, and Dignitas waiting, but Reflex. It's a good headshot on AC. Next in line is Dupree, and he's going to be going down as well to Disturbed. This is almost match and map point for 3D Max.
Now this is when it starts to get out of control. 3D Max, they realize they need to push, and they're going for all of the risky plays. Plays into Lower Dark like this, and it actually works. Dignitas not able to cope. Dignitas are going to be able to sneak their way out onto Long, but Corona's still alive on that A site, and he's got support here from Exart with that AWP, so Long control is going to be very tough for Dignitas to get. They have to use their nades intelligently here. Use the smoke to block off Cross and try and just get out if they can actually get Fetish to cause a bit of a diversion, but the AWP, not exactly the best weapon for this.
No, it isn't. I don't know how they're going to make it through here. The one thing working for them is the time left, and the fact that Exart and Disturbed are kind of low on health. They need a really good entry frag. Then they need to get the bomb down and need to hold it for a long time. Fetish in the middle gets found. He was looking for that distraction like you were talking about, but now the game is up 2-on-5 here. And Device and Sipnix, they're going to go for it.
No, they're not waiting around. Sipnix is already taking heavy fire, and they're just going to get crunched on despite the smoke. Corona's landing a shot. Sipnix is going to go for the plant again. Exart just barely on the edge, but he's going to get closed in on. He still gets the plant again. Sipnix manages to get that bonus money for his team. Yeah. At that point, that's what's keeping his team, his hopes alive, because that bonus 800 is going to go a long way towards giving them a healthy buy here.
Well, only two of the Dignitas members could have bought previous to this, so I'm curious to see how many they're going to be able to come up with here. Because how much they can buy makes all the difference. They're now fighting for overtime. The Finns are very close to making this work.
Yeah, this is amazing to see it. 3D Max. It's one of the biggest upsets.
Oh, this would be a massive upset.
Incredible. They've already taken out Copenhagen Wolves. Are they just going to be like the Dane Killers?
This is far bigger than NIP losing to LDLC or Titan. In my opinion. Mm-hmm. Far bigger.
All right, well, here we go. Dignitas, they're going for some pressure out mid-doors. They're looking to see if they can catch anybody here in CT. Disturbed holding the angle. Wild spray, and they're going to get a one-for-one trade. Reflex manages to catch Dupree in the back before he can make it through.
They're all shooting out there, and yeah, through the smoke and everything. The bomb's actually up there, so... Ooh, Ixart not going for the shot through. Device will pick him off. That's a very cool shot right through the wall then. 2-on-2, and the Danes fighting hard right now to extend it to overtime. That's what they need. Three rounds in a row. It starts with this one, and 3D Max don't have infinite money either. So if they lose a couple of rounds here, they might have a sort of automatic loss. And there's Device picking up a second kill. Now Reflex coming in, and he's going to get a great headshot. AC now knows where he is, but this one-on-one is very tense, and Reflex, been playing well all day, rushes up and has the knife out? Maybe slightly insane at the end, but there was very little time left. I'm wondering if he didn't think AC was on the other side of the wall. Bit of an assumption to make, I know, but that's the only explanation I come up with.
You're right, and at that point, not having that much time to work with, you could see right there when that round ended, when Reflex got that kill, or when AC rather got the kill on Reflex, that there wasn't much time left on that bomb. Mm. So he must have been under pressure just thinking, okay, I gotta take a risk, and he goes for it. Doesn't spot Reflex in time, because Reflex was just crouching right there, and if you don't notice just the pale turban, It's not going to work. I mean, it blends in with the box.
Oh, Device with the opening frag here. It's not. Oh, we've turned 90 degrees and takes down Reflex. It can still happen, apparently. A Disturb did get an important reflag here. Natu trying to come through, shouldn't be able to. AC missing a big opportunity, but Device won't. He's all over the map here. And that's going to be a kill on Natu. Now a 4-on-2, and we got to bring up the scoreboard really quick. We have to see how much... Yeah, 3D Max have no... Oh, well, two people have money. The rest can't buy. So if they lose this round, overtime is not, you know, secured, but it's very close.
It's still touch and go. It's still a matter of touch and go. The Device is starting to feel it like this. He's a force in nature when he wakes up. He's done this for Dignitas so many times.
This is one hell of a game. Caron actually walking with his back turned. If Sipnix had looked to his left then, he would have found somebody. He does a double take. He's still going to walk out here and does pick up the kill. Now a 1-on-4 here. Disturb's going to pick up the one headshot, looking for more. But Device, of course it is. The quad kill. And look at the focus on the man who closest to the camera here. That's the guy we just saw with that 4 kill. Individual to play coming out here. More than anything, is that's what kept Dignitas in these last couple of rounds. 14 to 15, and 3D Max will only have two people that can really have anything.
That last kill, but this is it, you're right. Two rifles picked up here for 3D Max, three CZ-75s, decent number of nades, only one kit. This is the gear that 3D Max have to stop Dignitas, to stop them from getting to overtime. One round to decide it right here. If 3D Max pick it up, they're pulling off one of the biggest upsets in GO history and going into play on the main stage of Globen here,
yeah.
One of the biggest arenas in Sweden.
Now, I'm pretty sure most of the pressure right now is on Dignitas. And if 3D Max get that first initial CSET kill in, the hearts on the Danish players, they're going to be sinking immediately. Everyone knows what that initial CSET kill means. Flash here. Oh, leg shot through, actually. Device doesn't care about smoke or anything.
Device, he's dialed in right now. There's no evading him. There's no hiding. No trickery. Nice nade there onto Dupree. That's going to do a little bit of damage, but still, Device is taking point. He's looking for that entry frag still on this A site. In the meantime, 3D Max kind of drifting around long. They want to see if they can find an opening here, or at least catch the Dignitas member who's lurking.
They're taking it so slowly, Dignitas, and you've got to wonder if it's fear or if it's a calculated move here. They're moving into the middle. Disturbed's going to pick up the first one. Next in line is Fetish. He's missing the shots. Finally, they connect here. And he's going to pick up the second rifle instead of reloading. Sart putting shots through. Smoke's going to clear up here. AC's picked up Natu as well. They got the bomb site, and it is a 3-on-4. There is no kit right now on the CT side. So once that bomb goes down, things go from bad to worse. Sipnix, low on health, survives on 3. And the bomb planted. Now they got to move quick. And in upper dark, it's AC waiting, and that's hugely important.
And Device has got the AWP. He's already trained towards mid. This is big. Gets the frag. Corona's down. Now it's a 2-on-3 retake. 3D Max trying to run it in. AC finds Reflex. It's all down to XR. Now goes rushing through, but it's fitting. Device will get the frag that puts them into overtime. And Dignitas, they survive.
Yeah. And you know, some measured excitement coming out from the Danish team. Not quite, you know, overhyped yet, but I think they realized they just dodged a bullet completely.
A cannonball, man.
Yeah.
Like, that was nuke dodging right there.
Tomahawk missile.
Honestly, Dignitas, you could be sure that they're wondering what in blazes is happening. How are they putting up such a fight? But this is just impressive from both sides. From both sides, the 3D Max are able to put up this amazing performance, but also the Dignitas are able to run it back in these kinds of circumstances. It is going to be overtime once again here, second time in Group B.
Yeah. Device continues with the AWP. Can't blame them for that. Dignitas got to step it up if they want to continue. And 3D Max, they've been on the edge for so long. Can they close it out? They try for a very cool crunch towards the middle, coming two people from Catwalk and two people down the middle, and they actually catch Sipnix and Upper, but the thing is they've given up a lot of the A bomb site here, and if Dignitas realized that this was happening, they'd probably keep running up long,
yeah.
But because they don't know that, they don't have the information for it, they're leaving Device down here, and the reason for this is they actually, ultimately, they'd like for someone from 3D Max to go and check long, just see if anyone's there, but you can tell they're not. So Device is actually useless at this point until he either moves or somebody moves towards him.
Exactly. Somebody needs to be peeking him, but they're going to focus on Cat. It seems like Disturb sneaks his way into Upper Dark. That's going to open things up. Fetish with the headshot, and now Dignitas not wasting any time at all. They're going to speed right up. Molly goes out. That's not going to be good enough. They manage to overwhelm him too. Natu is down, and it's going to be Xart stepping in.
Device did actually make his way into the middle, but still... Oh, they get the kill here. Xart and Caron, and now while Device is coming up from mid, he's picked up a rifle. He's got a little bit of time and a single grenade, but I don't see a reflect. Sorry, Corona and Exart losing this.
No, this is way too close. They've got the good positions as well. Exart is already looking towards window. Device is trying to sneak his way in. Parting nade in there.
He wants noise.
He's only got 17 seconds, Anders. He just doesn't have the time.
That headshot was so close. We can kill both of them. Fine. He's going to be walking in here. No, he's not going to get it. Almost got that first headshot. If that had been an AK and it had been a kill, there's a very good chance he could have done that. Oh, so close. But 3D Max, they win it. I think they look a little bit scared here. But that's a very important round for them to win. Nicely done by them.
That's exactly. It's crucial, and not for multiple reasons. Obviously, they want to get the round, but it also secures their money for the rest of this half of overtime. Yeah. Because it's $10,000 starting money. They're going for AWPs, etc. That takes a huge chunk out of their money, their starting money for this overtime. So basically, them managing to secure that gives 3D Max a little bit of breathing room now. And they did do a fantastic job on the T side. So picking up any CT side rounds on 3D Max's side is going to be a win.
Yeah. It's a bit of a danger here. If they focus too much on the guy in the back, the pre-makes it through, but they had all their attention on the guy in the back and not so much on Disturb, who was close to middle, and Kuron actually pushing through the middle, or free up from short, is going to take down Device. Now things are looking bad for Dignitas again here. They're trying to make the crossover happen. Sipnix trying for a headshot. Grenade to follow up, but the Finns are already out of there. They're going to be able to put the bomb down here, I'm pretty sure. But whether or not they can win it is a different matter.
Yeah, AC with a great flank manages to pick up Disturbed as well in mid. That's going to slow things down here for 3D Max.
Oh, but look at this guy. One guy over here. That's now two in the B bomb site. Very far away. AC picks up a second kill. Fetish makes it down to pit. And because Natu's so far away, this is now not looking so good for 3D Max. They will pick up that one kill. But AC still alive.
Exactly. Natu just rotating now through into CT spawn. There's still Sipnix alive on that A site, and he's going to be able to play the boxes and just play for time. This bomb has had so much time to tick down, but Natu's going to manage to pick up the first one. And AC is the last man alive here in a 1v2 clutch situation. The bomb is planted for him. He just needs to get the diffuser. He goes for the shot, and he hits it! There's not enough time! AC just clutches it for Dignitas. He needed to land one shot.
Oh, look at Dupree. That one reaction says everything, straight up into the ceiling. Oh, that's a magical moment. We saw it earlier today, in fact, when it was existence on cash do it, but that was down to the very last nanosecond. I'm sorry, I can't help but be a little bit amused by that.
Incredible. And AC only had like 8 HP or something as well. They sneeze on him and he's gone. He catches a cold, he's done, and that was it. Incredible. Oh. Now 16-16 the score, and this is really...
And lower dark plate. Fetish this time comes up with the kill. 3D Max trying for that aggressive push. They might be able to catch Device here. He's not ready for it, and he actually almost gets the flick anyway. And the bomb is still in T-spawn. They got to be careful here, Dignitas. They can still lose this round.
I mean, they definitely don't have all full control here. Exart is still alive with the AWP. Misses a bit of a given shot there on long. He's going to have to fall back, change up the angle that he's going to hold from. Smokes are going to go down to block him off, and now this gets very dangerous for him.
Yeah, might be able to pick up a kill. He will. Almost point blank range. The no scope as well. Misses the next one, but he's done enough already. Sipnix will take him down, but it's 1-on-3. He's burning alive. He's going to have to get out of there somehow. And, well, 14 health. And no chance of putting down a bomb here, I think. Oh. Not that it matters, but...
He has the chance. They've backed off pretty far here, 3D Max. They're willing to let him get this bomb plant, pretty much, because they've just set up to make sure that he's boxed in. He has nowhere to go, basically. He has to go for the A side at this point, Sipnix, unless he can land a sick shot on somebody here from 3D Max. He looks like he's drifting towards Caron, but he's only got 27 seconds left.
He's going to be wondering, did they all disconnect? Because they're nowhere to be found. This is smart play. It's the last round of the house, so putting down the bomb is not going to make any difference for Sipnix. It's not like he's going to carry that money into the next half.
There's the steps. That's all the information 3D Max need. They hear the bomb plant go down, and Corona, he stops it from even happening.
Yeah, it's in very intelligent play. You can see that that wasn't just like an individual person who made that call, because every single member of 3D Max did it all at once. So probably Natsu made the call. Just all fall back. Play as far away as you can. We'll get him no matter what.
Mm-hmm.
Even if he puts the bomb down, makes no difference.
Yeah, this was just obscene by Exart, though. That no scope, that thing of beauty.
So, second half coming up. Remember, guys, we're looking at the first team to get 19 rounds. And right now, 3D Max is at 17. They're going for a B push immediately. Dupree is here, but he's missing the shots through. Does some damage, but not quite. They're going to trade him instantly. And now, AZ goes down. So, push successful.
Push successful. Device will manage to peck to catch somebody peeking at the doors, however. So, that's XR taken out. Good damage dealt to 3D Max as well. Reflex is down to 6 HP. Corona's at half HP. So, this is going to be very tough for them to hold, in fact. And Dignitas are starting to move in. to get that flank position in Upper Dark.
Now Corona even lower on health here. Device flashed completely, so Disturb is going to come up with the kill and a sick double. Now a 1-on-3. Dignitas could have definitely done it, but those flashbangs working out way too well for the Finnish team. And Fetish, well, he does get at the one headshot, but he's still running.
Well, I think now he just sees it. He's like, wait a second, I was flashed. I did get that kill after all, but he just doesn't have the time.
No, there's almost no time. Unless they just challenge him here, he shouldn't be able to find both of them. Walking around the corner, and Reflex picks that one up. 18, it's match and map point again for 3D Max. And Dignitas have to come up with something special to now try and fight for double overtime. That's where we're at here.
Exactly right. They have to play a perfect remainder of this half, Dignitas, if they want to just have a chance at getting to the semis tomorrow and playing in Globin. This is so tense. 3D Max now on 18 rounds, one round away, and Exart gets the long spawn and picks off Device. Device, no time to react.
Very tense moment here. Second kill comes in. Fetish is down. 3D Max are on the path. This time, they're not going to get derailed. In the normal time, they were at match and map point. They had the 15 rounds, and Dignitas had to fight back from 12 or 13 to get the overtime. Mm-hmm. And now the 3D Max team is saying, enough is enough. In the B-bomb site, where the action is going to happen, AC is the only one defending, and kind of close by is Dupree. I'm not sure this is enough. AC peeks up. That's a good headshot. He needs two more here. Almost gets a second one, but oh, he's going to pick it up. Dupree, what? It's going to be Exard now alone in a 1-on-2. How did this happen? 3D Max had a perfect position walking in here. Just one guy holding, his teammate coming in quick. Yeah, but now it's a 1-on-2 here. Smokes off the one. Got 30 seconds left. This would be an incredible clutch from Exart, and he's going to go aggressive. Oh. And he walks into the grenade, and Sipnik's going to take it. That was a bit of a miracle play from Dignitas, I've got to say.
Yeah, AC, that position right there, that was crucial. I mean, Dupree, Device, everybody's stepping in, but AC's position was insane. Then he manages to pick up the first one, stay alive, pick up another one. Just, yeah, great play there. And Dignitas now, they're one round away from taking this to a second round of overtime. 3D Max on the edge, teetering. They still have the money to go for a buy. But Dignitas do as well. So this is it. One round to settle it all here, Anders.
So it is down to grenade, raining down and does some damage to Koron. That's annoying, but it's not the same as an entry frag. Double overtime. If they can win this round, Dignitas, if not, a painful loss to a very, very high-performing 3D Max team. Another grenade, actually, also mostly tanking up on Koron. He's a magnet.
Oh, he doesn't land the shot. That was a golden opportunity.
Yeah, in the Fox position.
Oh, man. This is so very close. 3D Max, right now, they're gathering up for a cat play, it seems. Sipnix is moving into CT. He's going to be all ears right now to listen. If he hears anything on cat, he's instantly going to communicate that to his teammates. But this is a very standard way to hold. A lot of this rides on Device, though. He needs to land a shot. As 3D Max are going to push out on cat, Device is rotated over to long. He's not going to be in position. He's not going to be there in time to get this unless he can land it here.
Back again. They don't have a lot of grenades to cut him off with, and he's going to miss the shot. Sipnix goes down. Device goes down, and it falls apart. 3D Max just casually strolling into the bombsite, picking up those kills, and now Daisy falls. This time it's another 2-on-5, but a much worse one, and now a 1-on-5 here. Good game called. 3D Max on to Globin. And what a great performance here, and look at that. Way more excitement this time around. They take out Copenhagen Wolves. They also take out Dignitas. This has got to be an historic day for this 3D Max team. It's been a long time at least since they've been performing at anywhere near this level.
Yeah, the Dane Slayers, this was amazing. You can see Rich from Fragbite right there in the background taking pictures. And Petri, the organizer of Aces ROG, that tournament that this team came in second place at the last time they played on LAN. So he's here to witness them get into the playoffs now. Semis tomorrow at Globin. And this is going to be what it's all about. But, I mean, Dignitas, they fought. This was just two teams playing to their utmost.
Yeah, well-mannered all around, getting some handshakes here. That's the biggest upset I've seen in quite a while here. Very impressed. And look at those smiles on the Finns. Yeah, they might not get so easily excited, but they feel proud about that one, and as well they should. No doubt about it.
Oh, that's amazing. That's it, Anders.
I can't believe it. So that's the first day of DreamHack Stockholm coming to a close. Tomorrow is going to be infinitely better.
Yeah,
trust me.
Exactly. Tomorrow we go into semis.
Yeah, so 10 minutes past 1 o'clock is when we're going to be live. That's Central European time. So if you're in another time zone, which you probably are, we have always have a lot of Australian, American, Indian viewers tuning in. So definitely, guys, check your time zone schedule, whatever it is, and calculate from there. So yeah, 10 past 1 Central European time tomorrow. Same channel and almost the same cast as Bot, with the addition of Thorin as well. It's going to be good. And we'll be in global. We'll have a great audience, no doubt. It's going to be exciting. So you don't want to miss it. Cancel everything else and watch Counter-Strike.